Welcome to this brief guide on how to close a consumer Microsoft account. There can be numerous reasons why you may wish to close an existing Microsoft account, including security or privacy concerns, consolidation and simplification, or perhaps you simply are just no longer making use of it. Whatever the reason, today I am going to walk you through the easiest and fastest way to permanently close your consumer Microsoft account. Most people tend to simply do a web search for how to close their account and select the first link provided. Whilst this will eventually get you to where you need to go, it is convoluted and can be confusing for a lot of users. Clicking continue on the page you end up at then redirects you to a support page where you would then need to read through multiple paragraphs of text, which can make this process seem scarier than it should be, whilst also clicking continue with closing your account multiple times to eventually make progress. Instead of this, we can head straight to the page we need by opening a new tab in our browser and heading directly to the following site, aka.ms/closeaccount. I'll include both the short URL and the full page URL, just in case the short URL stops working, in the description of this video for you. If you aren't already signed in, you will be prompted to authenticate your account as we are heading into the privacy and security section of your account page. Once signed in, we can see a single page of information that details what closing our Microsoft account will entail. And we have a box to select what cool-off period we wish to have for being able to reverse this process, with options of either 30 or 60 days. This window allows us to reverse the closure request without losing any data, and I will show you how to do that in this video as well. Selecting Next brings us to the final page of the process. This page includes a checklist for us to fill in. Each of these items needs to be selected to ensure that you have read each item and agree to it. The key items here are that any data attached to the account, such as emails, files on OneDrive, Microsoft certifications, or purchases such as digital Xbox games or DLC, will be unrecoverable following the complete closure of your account. Before proceeding, please ensure you have read each of these and agree to it. At the bottom, there is a drop-down for you to select the reason you are closing your account. I am just going to say that I'm consolidating down to a single Microsoft account. Once you are ready to proceed, select Mark Account for Closure to complete the account closure request. And now we can see that our account is slated to be fully and irrevocably deleted in 60 days, as per my selection. But if we decide to change our mind inside this time window, we can reopen the account easily too. Let's walk through that process now. All we need to do is attempt to sign into the account, and we will be informed that the account is slated for deletion. We click on Reopen Account to reverse this. At this point, we will be asked to verify our request using our account's two-factor authentication option. In my case here, that is using the Microsoft Authenticator app on my mobile device. And it's that easy. My account has now been reopened and I have not lost any of my data. And that is how you quickly and easily mark a consumer Microsoft account for permanent closure and the steps to reverse that process. I hope you found this guide extremely valuable and it saves you plenty of time and hassle in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.